I haven't touched any of my mini flops, how much they have taken over my life. Between this size and the mini Kelly, if I could only choose one quota bag, it's not even a competition. In today's video, I'm gonna share with you five of my most used handbags and five that are not so obvious but least used handbags in my collection. We'll start off with my most used, and although I had a prediction that I would get a lot of use out of them, I just was so surprised by how much I enjoy them and literally how much they have taken over my life. By the way, if you're new here, hi, my name is Amy and welcome to my channel. So let me just talk about why I enjoy the 22 bag so much. Between the two size, which size I end up, you know, just kind of like literally it has taken over my life. And that would be the mini size. This size came out after the original larger sizes. I'll never say forever or never. So I can't say that they are forever bags, but I cannot see a foreseeable future where I'll get rid of them at all because they are so good. So let's start off with the mini size. By the way, on this mini size today, I adjusted the strap to be kind of the short shoulder carry, which is so cute. If you guys have not seen my review video where I showed you all the different ways and also the secret way to wear it even as an evening shoulder bag, this is how. I'll link to all the videos regarding all the bags that I'm gonna speak about in this video, but in any case, this bag literally took over my life. I travel with it, I go to the grocery shopping with it, I go to my doctor's appointment with it. Thankfully for this one, I haven't had any issues whatsoever with any of the leather rubbing, with any corner wearing. I mean, everything, I'm not even babying this bag at all. I travel with it, it was squished inside my carry-on when I brought it back home, and it has taken over my life. And if I could only have one bag, as of today, if I could only have one bag that I know will work 100% in my lifestyle and I couldn't buy any other bag, it would be this one. And that is saying a lot. That is a huge statement, don't you think? So if you're on the fence about the mini 22 and you're similar to me in a sense that you love smaller size bags, you love bags that are non-fussy, just goes with everything outfit-wise, lifestyle-wise, it's that good. Now, does it have its pros and cons? Yes. I always get questions as to like, how do I clean it or how do I protect it? If there was food that fell on it, I'll use like a little wet napkin and I'll just like buff it. The only wear and tear I would say is just some of the creases that you can't avoid on such an unstructured bag. And the only thing I would recommend is an organizer. Not to organize your things necessarily, but just to keep the shape of the bag a little bit better and also to protect the lining on the inside. So in the past, I've always recommended Samorga. I know a lot of you guys also like Zomoni, and they have come up with a brand new product, which thank you to them for sending me their prototype. I don't like a lot of pockets in my organizers because I really just use them as liners. I prefer to just line my things in the fashion that I do. So in this one, I only asked them to add a lipstick holder, which is the perfect size for my hand sanitizer. I just love knowing that my hand sanitizer is in one place and it's the perfect space for it. I don't know if it's officially the way they're gonna make it, but originally they did use a 2mm felt and then they wrapped it with this satin material, and I didn't like that it was that thick, at least for this small bag. For this size, maybe I would prefer the 2mm felt and then the satin over it, but for this size, which is just a small little mini bag, I prefer the 1.2mm felt and then the satin over it. So I actually quite like it like this. A new product that they're gonna launch soon, I think, their satin or silky line. Don't know if you can see because it's a little dark, but yeah, I honestly cannot highly recommend this bag any more than I already do. What are some of the obvious cons? Well, it's kind of expensive for such an ugly design, and ugly in quotation because I think it's actually kind of cute. If you're looking for an investment for or your next investment handbag, I don't know if you'll get it with this. At the moment, they're still very, very popular and they will still, you know, if you made a mistake, you can probably still rehome it and get most of your money back. But I wouldn't say that it's a classic by any means that you can just have as an investment, right? In quotation again. But other than that, I would say they have fixed any of the leather issues that I've had in the past, such as the rubbing. I haven't had any corner issues underneath the straps. I just checked. The pros for me really outweighs the cons. And yeah, only you would know if you own the bag how good it is. Literally everybody that got their hands on a mini have said the same thing. They think that this bag has literally taken over and they cannot rotate out of it because it's that good. Let's talk about the small size. So this is their original larger size hobo 22 bags. So this is the small, there's a medium, and there's a large, and there's also the backpack version. This size is good if I need to throw in like a little jacket inside, a little scarf inside, or just more things in general. Like on days that I definitely cannot get away with a mini, this is the next best thing. If you're not used to having thicker chains or just slightly more weight on your shoulders, maybe you have an injury, then you will feel it a little bit more, especially because you can definitely fill this bag. So that is definitely a con. Another con that I have experienced since this is my second one now, the first version that I got, I had peeling issues with the leather. It seems like Chanel has fixed it because I haven't heard anybody else complain about it. Also, if you're just paranoid and you just don't want that to happen, you can get the protective little inserts in the corners, and I'll show you the ones that I have. I highly recommend them. They have been great, and they're just a lifesaver. Other than that, on the outside of the bag, I haven't had any issues, any peeling, any corner wear. The leather is wrinkled, but that is just a normal wear and tear for this type of structure. Yeah, I would say the obvious con for this one is the loose structure, because it is on the bigger side on top of that. If you don't have any sort of organizer to really prop up the structure, it will kind of become a sack. It will look like more of a garbage bag. So I always recommend that you get an organizer for this size especially. So in here I still have my Samorga. Samorga is still for me the most tightest fit. So I recommend them. So I always love having an organizer in this bag. And I would say equally, the other con is that it is prone to wear and tear in the corners. Why? Because it is a heavier bag, because of the design that it is. This is just leather, so after a while, and if you're constantly using this bag and you have a heavier bag in general, you will get wear and tear the leather here. It's just kind of part of the design. It's inevitable. It is a huge con, especially if you have any of the larger sizes. You need to get the protectors. I don't care which one you get, just get some of them, because they will really preserve the long-term use of your bag, and you will also use your bag a little bit more freely. You'll be more happy to use it. So I have the one that I definitely recommend from this company, MRA. And they are a Canadian company, and I love the fact that theirs come in so many different colors, and it is also made of genuine leather. It's pliable, and they're super easy to install. Again, for the mini size, it was perfect. I haven't had any problems, not even corner wear, but it is a smaller bag. It's not as heavy. This one is a lot heavier, and also it's just more prone. Also, because I had issues on my first one, so I definitely did not want to take the chance on the second one. If you haven't already, I highly, highly recommend that you get these, because they are definitely a lifesaver. They do come in a multitude of colors. Obviously, if you have a very colorful bag, I don't know if you'll match 100%, but if you have a black one, it will be seamless. You won't even be able to see it. I would say between the two 22 bags that I own, they are pretty much my surprisingly most used bags. Ever since I got them, they have been literally taking over my life. This larger size also comes with this pouch. It is kind of nice to have a pouch as an additional item when you purchase this bag, because it can become a clutch. This chain is obviously aftermarket chain, but it's so cute. It looks like a Chanel chain and it's sold at Emery as well, so I'll link to it as well. I want to switch gears a little bit and show you one of the bags that, and I consider this a bag, that I literally have almost not used it. The only times I have used it was when I first got it, but ever since coming home with it, I haven't really used it. And I think, I mean, I'll show you which one it is, and it's, I think it's pretty self-explanatory why it's sort of like a, it's kind of like a novelty piece, right? This is the Hermes Constant Slim, and of course it's gorgeous. This is in lizard skin and rose gold hardware, so it's so gorgeous, guys. Like, the color and just the combination of leather is absolutely stunning. So why don't I use it more? It basically is pretty much a belt bag, and so unless I'm wearing some sort of belt that also goes with my outfit and I also want a belt bag at the same time, I wouldn't really get any chance to wear it. So that's flaw number one. And flaw number two is that it is a really, really tiny bag. Obviously, it doesn't fit a phone, so that alone will restrict a lot of when I can get use out of this. So I'm really, really excited to share with you a, it's not really a secret, but I've been working with, again, Emery to create this custom product just for the Constant Slim. I think one of the main issue that I have is that mine is exotic. It's super thick leather, and so it's definitely not going to fit as much as if you have it in Epsom or in Evercolor. So you're going to even benefit more than I am. My requirements are, obviously, it has to stay inside the bag. It has to be so thin that it's not taking up any space inside the bag. That was one of my main requirements. And I also want the product to be good quality, that you could, you know, feel the quality of it. So this is the insert that we came up with. You basically just slide it in. So right now I emptied the content. You slide it in and it stays in like this. The problem I have with a lot of third-party inserts for this bag is that it literally is so thick, it takes up all the space, and I didn't like that. You still have access to the back pocket, just you have to put your cards behind this. But this is why I was so picky, because I was always really worried that the inserts would also damage the edge of the leather good. Obviously, this is a very expensive piece. I don't want it to be damaged. So this little bit of leather poking out is basically gonna take the pressure off of any hardware or anything like that, and therefore it won't damage your bag. So you're just gonna attach your strap over it and you'll be able to use it, and it's not budging, which is why for me, after all the back and forth, this is the best design that we both agree is gonna work the best, at least to my standards, because I'm literally the most picky person in the world. So if you already have some sort of strap, such as if you have a Mini Kelly, you could definitely use your Mini Kelly strap, or you can also get their straps from MRA, so I'll show you that later. And it will look something like this. Super, super cute, and it won't damage the bag, as you can see there, and it's also taking up very minimal space. For example, like a lip gloss, in the past with the other inserts, I wouldn't be able to put it in because it simply is, see how narrow it is, this bag, and also because this leather is so thick. In the past, I wouldn't even be able to put a lip gloss if I had an insert inside, but now I totally can. And yeah, there you go. So this is their adjustable leather strap. So that's definitely an option, but I'm also gonna try their fixed length, because sometimes I don't really like hardware on my straps. But yeah, this is how it looks like for if you were to get their straps. I think after this, I will definitely be able to get more use out of this, because it's so beautiful. And the fact that it's my least used is definitely such a waste, and I'm not ready to part with it, because I mean, it's rose gold, it's lizard, it's just stunning. Okay, moving on to the next bag that I will say I pretty much haven't touched in a long time. I can honestly say that I haven't touched any of my mini flops in like a year, which is so crazy to say and to think, because I've always recommended the mini flap. There's so many bags from Chanel, but at the end of the day, if you're gonna go for your first bag, I still really, really do recommend the minis. But for myself, in my own collection and in the past year, I haven't really touched my minis, and that is so crazy. It's so crazy that literally the other day I went to a concert with my daughter, and this is the bag that I had to bring. I had to force myself to use it because I just felt so bad. But it just goes to show that when something is so good, such as the Chanel 22 mini, you really, really have to take the effort to make sure that you rotate your other bags as well. So although it is one of my least used, literally, it's not going anywhere. Don't worry, I'm not selling my minis anytime soon or ever. But it is definitely still one of my least used. One of the cons of the rectangular mini is that the chain is uber super long. And so whenever I want to wear it as a short, maybe shoulder wear, it's always too long, especially if you're not at least 5'7" or taller. So recently I added this clip to shorten the strap just by this much. You just slide it in and open in the middle, and they are great. I know in Asia they give them out for free, so if you shop in Chanel Asia, you can just ask, but in North America we don't have that. We don't have it, so you can just buy it from Emray. It's really, really cheap anyway. So unfortunately, my minis have been taking a back seat, but I love them nonetheless. It's just that they are definitely one of my least used. Switching gears again, let's show you something that I surprisingly use quite a bit. And I don't know if it's a honeymoon phase or if it's just because it's such a big investment in my collection and the journey to get it that I value it so much. But I think it's more than that. I think it's just part of my aesthetic a lot. I really, really love the silhouette, and I have just found it to be one of the most suitable for my lifestyle. Now, do I use it as much as the 22? Not by a mile, not even. But and it's crazy because it's one of those super hard to get bags. It's a quarter bag. The Kelly from Hermes has definitely been one of my most used. So I think I'm more of a Kelly girl. I mean, I'm never really gonna get rid of my Birkin because they're both so amazing. But I think between the Birkin and the Kelly, especially in this size, I just gravitate towards the Kelly a bit more. It's a great size. I will say between this size and the mini Kelly, it's not even a competition. This is just a better size. Don't get me wrong, I love the mini Kelly, but in terms of my quota bags, I think I have been using the Kelly more. And I just love the fact that it's so cool looking when it's open like this. Yes, I do close my bags, but I do like to see them open because they look so good. Maybe it's also the strap. The fact that it does have a shoulder strap, to me, it helps. Not that I'm wearing it on the shoulders all the time, but I just love having the option. I also love the bigger handle. And yeah, the Kelly aesthetic to me is just chef's kiss. Again, it's not to say that the Birkin is not amazing, because like I said, I love my Birkin, okay? This is the Birkin 25. It's only slightly bigger and only slightly heavier than my Kelly, but for some reason between the two, I just love the Kelly slightly more, just by a hair. And yeah, the Birkin is great, especially the combination I have it in. I'm just so happy with it. I'm just so glad that I was so picky and I stuck with the exact combo I want. But in terms of I think if I could only choose one quota bag and I can only have one, literally, the Kelly 25 is for me a no-brainer. But do I use it as much as the 22? No, not at all, because I don't want to put all that kind of casual wear and tear in it. I do baby this one, definitely. But it has been surprisingly my most used quota bag. And that, I think, it says a lot that probably I'm more of a Kelly girl, I think. So yeah, I love the Kelly 25, especially this black and gold. Chef's kiss. It's literally so good. So good. Let's talk about some non-quota bags. One of the more versatile one that is also spacious and just kind of under the radar that I really highly recommend is still the Picotin 18. And again, I do have a more special version because I do have the exotic handle one. So this is the Picotin 18 Touch. Love this spaciousness, and you can see the silky organizer in there. I love the spaciousness. I love how sort of under the radar it is. You can't tell the brand if you don't know it. And it's really an easy bag. Now, does it have its cons? Absolutely, yes. I think if you have the regular version, it will definitely have more of the slouching, which, you know, to me, I am kind of glad that I have the special version. The other problem, which is the main problem, is that it's really just a top handle bag. I do highly recommend this strap. I cannot tell you how many times I've thrown this over my shoulder, and it's kind of a lifesaver, although I wouldn't recommend that you wear the bag like this all the time, but having this strap just really just, oh, it's such a lifesaver. I'm gonna link it down below. This one is so nicely made, almost very similar to the original leather. But yeah, in terms of non-quota bags, I will say this bag has not surprised me, but it definitely exceeded my expectations how much I love it, because this is one of the cheaper non-quota bags that you can get at Hermes. They're not easy to get by any means, but they're definitely a little bit more accessible. You can sometimes still get them online. And so I definitely recommend it. I definitely recommend this bag. Switching gears again, let's talk about the Chanel 19. Is it already passé? Is it not relevant anymore? I don't think so. I mean, look at it. It's so gorgeous. In my opinion, it looks better than the 22 bag. It just does, okay? It's just a nicer bag. But for some reason, I haven't reached for it as much. And it has nothing to do with the functionality of the bag because it's super functional. I've raved about this bag for many years now. And I still use it, but it's just so minimal that I kind of have to make the effort. Perhaps also the fact that it's slightly less versatile than the 22, because with the 22, there's something about it that is so casual that no matter what your outfit looks like, it kind of still works. For example, with the mini, right? It's so simple and it's so casual, but for some reason, if you had to go to a wedding, it works. It's just like a little shoulder bag, kind of like, you know, it's just nice, and it works. But with this one, it's a little too grungy. So I think in terms of versatility, the 22 really is, you know, it is amazing. Also, the 19 is trending a bit less now. So I think those reasons alone, I have been wearing it a little bit less. But is it going anywhere? No, I don't think so, because it's still a great bag. I think in terms of construction and everything, it's still superior. I really do still love it. I have been trying to rotate. But yeah, I do think that it's one of those things about trends that when time passes, you just kind of don't gravitate towards them as much. But is it not a beautiful, amazing bag and also one of Carl's last designs? It is. So I feel like it's just one of those things that, you know, over time I will definitely grab it more, but as of right now, it is definitely one of my least used, and it's kind of sad. Sometimes I look at these bags and I'm just like, oh, they're so nice, but I definitely don't use them as much and I should. Another bag that I am super surprised that I don't use it more, it is the Nano Speedy. again, the nano line is making a comeback, which I'm kind of glad, but in a way, I'm just wondering if it's more to do with my lifestyle or if it's just the look. There's just something about this bag that I haven't reached for. Definitely there are some major cons, which is that it is not the easiest to get in and out, and I've always had a love-hate relationship with Speedies that just deters me from wanting to reach for it. I think that's the main issue, because other than that, it's such a classic at LV. If I'm gonna get any bags at LV, I always think about their canvas. I don't really gravitate towards their leather bags as much, even though I do have one that I use a lot. This one for me is still a piece that I bought, obviously for the fashion aspect of it, but I also thought that I would make more use out of it, which I haven't. But I sometimes still do wonder that if I don't have it anymore, would I, you know, kind of regret it and wish that I still kept it. Again, this is the newer nano size, so it is the one that has the detachable strap. So an option that I thought would be so adorable that way. And I feel like this is more the vibe that I would go for this bag. This is an aftermarket vachetta strap. It's on the thinner side. It has the red glazing and it will patina over time to match the patina of it. This is the fifth least used bags. I think I can probably, yeah, I think I can confidently say that I haven't used it for like a year or more, because I don't know why. I think it's also because of the 22. Again, the 22, it's sort of just more my vibe. It looks more cool, and I just really love the 22 bag. Does it mean that there's anything wrong with the Neverfull? No, because, you know, if I'm gonna have one bag from LV, it has to be the Neverfull, because it's one of those things. I always think of canvas when I think of LV, and this is such a classic and really robust tote that is also on the simpler side, so not too much bells and whistles. It's not too heavy. Some people will find the straps a little bit on the thinner side, and it's an open tote, so it's not all perfect. But I also can't make myself get rid of this, because although I haven't used it in a long time, I feel like it's just one of those things that you have to have in your collection. So at the moment, it's not going anywhere, of course, but it is one of my least used, and it is a bit shocking and sad, which is my fifth and final most used bag. It is none other, and it's not very expensive, super, super affordable, Longchamp. These are the two that I own in this size. So this is the smallest size that is a top handle. I think on their site, they just call it small. I don't know. I'll just link it below, because obviously there are many different sizes of the Longchamp tote bag. I am just such a fan of their top handle version, because first of all, it's one of those things that if I were to compare to the Speedy 25 or 30, for me, the Longchamp is just a better bag. I don't know how else to put it. You know, in terms of canvas, it's super durable, it's so lightweight, it's so carefree. In terms of opening, they both are kind of fussy. This one has a flap, which kind of you have to contend with. But what I like about the top handle version is that I just yank it like this. I don't really close it, and I just grab it and I go like this. But it's also the size and the weight and just how carefree they are that literally, of all my beautiful, super expensive bags, this and this one are some of my most used. I really feel like bags should not only complement your outfit, but sometimes it has to complement your lifestyle. When it comes to lifestyle, sometimes there are just places that I really cannot take my nicer bags. I just cannot, because maybe it's that part of town. A couple of my subscribers asked me about the little cosmetic size. The cosmetic size is actually really, really amazing, because it fits your wallet, your essentials, and your phone. I really, really love this color when it came out, which I guess it's pretty obvious because I got both of them. I have used it as a bag. I've also used it inside a bag as a little pouch. So it's super versatile. I totally, totally recommend their cosmetic pouch, and if you want to, you could also convert it into a handbag. So this is a conversion kit that I added on this. It has a little hook that goes underneath the leather, and so yeah, it just works out so well as a little crossbody if you want to convert your Longchamp top handles or cosmetic case. They are different sizes, by the way, so you have to buy the right size conversion kit. I can't rotate out of these two bags, these two 22 bags. They're just so great, and I don't know what it is. I mean, I know, but I don't know. It's just one of those things that literally these two bags have taken over my life, and it's making it that much harder to rotate my least used bag. I hope this video was interesting and also helpful if you've been needing some help with the accessories. Share with me your most and least used bags in the comment section. I'll have everything linked down below. I'll also pop a couple of videos that you might be interested. If you haven't already, please do subscribe. Again, my name is Amy, and I'll talk to you guys next time. Bye!